Hello, good afternoon. This afternoon I was coming home from the store and lo and behold, I saw a whole bunch of mushrooms feeding on, I guess it's leftover of sod that was just laid. So they were arranged very neatly around the sod. So I took one and threw it in my shopping cart and brought it home because I figured looking at a mushroom was high priority for me. I've done it before, but I don't think I had the technique I have now, and I wasn't able to see very much. At any rate, when I was in school, things were simple. There were only three kingdoms in the world. One was animal, one was vegetable, and one was mineral. Since then, things have gotten a lot more complicated and more sophisticated, and the fungus, the mushroom, is a kingdom all its own, equivalent to animals and vegetables, but not really the same. For one thing, the cell walls in the mushroom are made out of chitin, which is the same stuff that is on the shell of a beetle or the skin of a the hard outer skin of an insect, and the cell wall of a vegetable is made out of a different material altogether. So in many ways, the mushroom, it has a little bit of a relationship to animals, and in its separateness. They look different too. When you examine the cell structure in the mushroom, the cells seem to be very tight together, whereas with vegetables, the cell walls are separated by a wide barrier made out of cellulose, which is, I guess, the substance that paper is made out of. The mushroom reproduces by spreading spores. Spores are like primitive seeds. Seeds are self-contained units which contain even the nutrients, so that the growing plant inside the seed can survive for some time without any external nutrients. But a spore requires full support in order to grow, so it's more primitive than the seed. Anyway, it's a lot of interesting differences, and I found the journey through a mushroom be very satisfying. In some ways, it's quite graceful. It looks like a volcanic half liquid stone. Anyway, take a look.